All right, everyone, here we are with ticker symbol DKNG, DraftKings Inc. And before we jump into this chart, I want to say welcome to all my first time viewers and investors. Welcome to my channel, Invest for Tomorrow. To all my subscribers, welcome back, and let's jump into this chart. So I was watching yesterday, which it kind of ties in a little bit with DKNG, and I was watching yesterday the fight between Roy Jones Jr. and Mike Tyson. Pretty much two great legends. They are over the age of 50. We were expecting a crazy and phenomenal fight. It was an exhibition, so it's not really a fight. It was more of like a, you know, sparring battle and just, you know, swinging and having some fun on the ring, but obviously trying to see if there was a contestant, right? Somebody would have to win the sparring battle. But turned out that kind of devastated some people's expectations. And I mean, I would love to see your guys' comments down below. What are your guys' thoughts on what boxing has become? Do you think that boxing is going to go that route? Like, is that what it's going to look like in the ring? Because to me, it was a little bit awkward watching two men and then there was nothing in the background. It was just, you know, blank. They made it like a dark area where you could focus in on the boxers, and it almost looked like a video game, which was kind of like I said, awkward. It didn't feel like the boxing match. And then you hear the commentators in the background, you hear the trainers and everybody talking at the same time, and there's no like crowd noise, there's no crowd, you know, it's just centered in on two people, which is what it's all about. But the crowd gives it some life. It was kind of like just a room and some lights and being recorded. It was kind of different, something new, I guess, to everybody. There was a few other fights there that were interesting, but this was the main event, and it hit me because there's some key points. I'm gonna show you guys recordings that I did about the fight, and I want you guys to go ahead and pay close attention to what is going on those moments. So I'm going to kind of jump over to that, and then we're going to jump over to the chart, some news that I have about the chart, how it reacted to these points leading up to this point, and what is expected for DKNG. So stay tuned till the end of the video. I have a lot of information for everyone. For those of you that are bullish, you guys might like this video. For those of you that are bearish, there might be some information here for you guys as well. So look forward to seeing you guys. Hit that thumbs up if you find this video helpful and informative. And if you're a first-time viewer, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a single video that I post. So stay tuned till the end. Let me go ahead and put the other video up, the short clip, and we're going to be right back to the chart.
In between rounds here, they are just leaning on each other. And again, let's not forget.
Go ahead, Roy, get smart,
Roy, that clipped him with the left.
Go ahead, Roy, get smart.
Look at him, look at him off, Roy.
Use that jab. Mike's all yes.
Wow. Mike. Double left. And yet Jones
absorbing.
That's not good.
There's a new Mike Tyson.
Yeah, a new Mike Tyson.
You guys saw at the end of that video, there was a moment where DKNG actually pops up. Not only that, but you can see it in the ring. I'm not sure if there's a moment there in that video that it shows it, but you could see it in the ring. For those of you that were watching it yesterday, you could also see it in the ring. But what really stood out to me is that it was coming up in the ring, it came up in the back screen, and it came up as a bar on the bottom. I know that DKNG has been advertising everywhere. They've been doing advertisements, you know, in different commercials, in different locations. They're all over the sports channel. So this is becoming a revolutionary type of thing that DKNG is going to be part of sports in the near future. And it already is, but it's going to become much more encrypted into sports, and it's going to become a norm. And to see it there sponsoring, I believe, or if it was advertising, I'm not sure. If anybody wants to go ahead and correct me on that, if that was sponsorship that it was doing or advertising on that event, it was pretty interesting. And what does that mean for DKNG? Well, DKNG has been running up. I don't know if you guys remember, but Jordan also announced that he was becoming part of the board of directors back in September 2nd. And This ran up from the day he announced it, or it was announced, on $36 all the way up to $43. That was a pretty big jump just from his announcement. But from that point forward, it's been running up. Now, there was another thing that happened, which was insider trading. And the board of directors, I believe one of the directors, he sold most of his shares back on the 9th of October. And you could see that it had an effect here on the chart. I mean, I can actually look it up so that we could see it in just a moment. But I want every single person to be aware that this right here had an effect on continuing it in downward direction. I guess some people started liquidating, not only him, but other large institutions and also individual sales from investors, you know, fear, uncertainty. And it brought this down to about $34 and some change. Something I want to point out is that if it ever breaks through that point, it would start to see newer lows. I highly doubt that this is going in that direction anytime soon. This has been growing exponentially since that point forward. If anybody wants to correct me, like I said, if DraftKings was sponsoring the event or advertising at it, because if it was sponsoring the event, some of this catalyst has to do with that, and also bullish outlook on this company for most investors, if it's becoming more of a norm. Another thing too, DraftKings has to do with betting, like Penn National Gaming, and that's not completely legal in every state, I believe. And if it does become legalized or become a norm, like I said, it's going to have a big impact on these companies, and these companies are going to soar as long as sports continue to exist. Now, if one of the directors actually sold back in this time, the date that one of the directors sold. So Jordan became part of the directors in September 2nd or 3rd, somewhere around that time it was announced. And it does, in the article that I found, it states that, you know, there's no disclosure yet how he's going to get paid, but most likely he's going to get shares. One of my best advice to every single investor is look up at how many insiders or directors or CFOs or different people in the company, DKNG, because there might be some insider selling that still hasn't finished happening. And these are so far the ones reported. And if there is any in the near future, it might have some type of effect. But the fact that one of the directors sold about 1.5 million shares worth up to $78 million, it had an effect because it actually brought this in this direction. So that's why it's going to be important to pay close attention to any future sales by any directors or any insiders, because it could have take a toll on the stock. It could actually affect it slightly. And you can notice that because when they did it back in June 18, 23rd, all of these insiders, directors, and CFOs, you could see it here that it actually had an effect. It started to fall. From that point forward, it started to fall. All the way back from the 18th, it actually started, and then it just continued. So it's very important to pay close attention to these insider trades. And one of the ones that had the biggest effect was the recent director. Now, it makes other institutions get out. It makes other investors be fearful, uncertain, and clocking out. So we need to pay close attention to any future director sales or insider sales or CFO sales or COO sales or any type of high position authorities in the company. So we need to watch that. Now, what does this mean for the outlook? Well, I thought it was very interesting to see Dkng in the event and, you know, participating in advertising or sponsoring in that. And if it continues to pop up in many events or many sport events, better said, I believe this is going to continue to grow. And here is some information from some of the forecasts and analysis on TipRank. So here we see that it's saying an average price, you know, of 60.57. That's like the midway point. When you look at this from 22 analysis, They're saying it's a moderate buy, and it says 15 buy and 7 hold. I mean, that's a really good, you know, standpoint. Nobody is saying sell. Worst case scenario is that it touches again the 39 mark, which is pretty close to the lows that this reached. But I highly doubt that it will get close to those numbers if it continues in this trajectory of innovation and growing. And the high end is saying $100. This could fall anywhere between $60 to $100 within the next 12 months. This is a 12-month forecast. This is going to be very interesting to pay close attention to. But the fact that I saw it at that event, it really opened my mind to saying like, whoa, like I forgot all about the fight. I was just focused on stocks. I was like, Dkng has been growing from those lows, and I don't think it's going to touch anywhere near those lows again. I think it could just grow from here, and it certainly has been growing, and we need to watch it closely still. The forecasts are saying that it's going in the upward trend. No one's saying sell. Everyone's saying hold or buy. And some of the biggest director, you know, have already sold their shares. Now, the question is, how many more directors are there? And now that Jordan was appointed recently as a director, when is he going to sell his shares? That's what we need to watch for. Because when that happens, it doesn't mean that it destroys the chart, but you need to watch it closely. There's some great opportunity here. I look forward to seeing your guys' comments down below on the fight, on Dkng, and what you guys think. And I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. If you're a first-time viewer and found this video helpful and informative, please do so and subscribe. Don't forget to click on the bell to turn on all notifications and not miss a single video that I post. Share this with your friends and community. And don't forget to hit the like button to let me know you watch this video. Thank you guys so much for watching.